I'd like to talk to you about my problems before we start. Geniuses, I'm GDY and I've got a problem. I'd like to talk to you about my problems before we start. Which of two hairstyles do you think suits me? So this uptone style or this idol hairstyle like BTS? I'm torn. These both look good on me. The muscles we will study today can have a severe effect on the body type imbalance in your ankles and knees. Today's main focus is the soleus muscle. First, let's draw. Take a picture of the posterior of your leg. Draw your fibula, tibia, and foot bones on the picture. The soleus muscle starts from the posterior surface of the proximal fibula and cellular line of the tibia. Also, it attaches to the dorsum of the calcaneus via the calcaneal tendon. Try drawing the size too. What is the first function of the soleus? Let's look at the soleus besides. When the tibia and fibula are fixed and the soleus shortens or experiences concentric contraction, should the heel of your foot go up or down? The calcaneus bone will be pulled up by the soleus. When the calcaneus bone is pulled up, what are the bones in front of your feet? They will move downward. When the soleus muscle concentrically contracts, the ankle joint will stretch in plantar flexion. On the other hand, let's think about when your feet are fixed. We spend more time standing or walking with our feet fixed to the floor. When the calcaneus bone is fixed, the soleus shortened or concentrically contracted, should the tibia and fibula bone move backward or forward? The soleus is attached behind the tibia and fibula bone. These bones will move backward. When the soleus muscle concentrically contracts, the ankle joint will stretch in plantar flexion. If the ankle is flexed bottom of the foot and the foot is on the floor, the ankle will form a plantar flexed posture. The ankles are the same position. The difference is whether your feet are attached to the floor or not. But can we stand with a plantar flexed posture of the ankle? I will try to stand with my ankle in a plantar flexed posture. You look like you wanna try the same. It's impossible, but as people stand with their ankles forming a plantar flexed posture. Look at these pictures. The ankle is in a plantar flexed posture. To stand in this posture not against the wall, make sure that the knee joint is in a hyperextended posture. Most of the back knee patients I met so far have had their ankle in a plantar flexed posture. I got it, I misjudged that there was an excellent tool that could stand in the plantar flexed posture not against the wall. Yes, I'm making short soleus and back knee. The back knee can be shorter than the normal length of the soleus muscle, which makes the ankle plantar flexed posture. Of course, the back knee has excessive internal rotation of the femur bone, poor support of the tibialis anterior muscle. The internal rotation of the talus bone should also be considered. These are the things that we have to study regularly in the future. If the soleus is shorter than the normal length, the dorsiflexion of the ankle joint will be limited, right? Of course, you have to consider the peroneus longus muscle, gastrocnemius muscle. Do you want to make sure your soleus is short or normal? Testing this is straightforward. Assume the prone position and bend your knees 90 degrees. Try dorsiflexion of your ankle joint. Be careful to avoid inversion or eversion of your ankles. Make sure that the angle of dorsiflexion of the ankle is at least 20 degrees. You also may check this test passively with your client. Observe your lateral posture when you're squatting. If the length of your soleus is normal, when the feet are fixed to the floor, at least 20 degrees of the dorsiflexed position of the ankle should be achieved. A person with a short soleus is limited in their ability to achieve dorsiflexion of the ankle, so they can maintain this posture when they're doing squat. Let's summarize the body types in which the soleus muscle will be shorter than normal. A body type in which the ankle joint is plantar flexed posture. Movement limitation of dorsiflexion at ankle joint. Do not just sit there and watch. Act on it. Don't just look at it, make it yours. You can do it. First, you take a picture of your leg. Second, draw the soleus muscle. Try to test the length of the soleus muscle. Take a video when you're squatting. So think about it, is my soleus length is normal or abnormal? You can tear it up. The soleus muscle. If you want to see more pictures, check on my Instagram. I hope today's video will help you to be a genius of body types. See you soon, guys.